In this video, we're going to show you how to upgrade your class to version 3.5 software and hardware. Before you get started, you need the new version 3.5 EEPROMs, a Phillips head screwdriver, and the OK Industries model EX2 40-pin EEPROM extractor tool. Next, we're going to take the lid off the class. Before we take the lid off the class, disconnect any power so that there is no electrical shock hazard. The clasp has 9 screws that hold the lid secure. Next, let's remove the screws that hold the lid. Next, let's carefully remove the lid from the clasp. Make sure that the clasp is oriented so that the front panel is facing you. This is very important so that the orientation of the EEPROM chips is done correctly. The two EEPROM chips are located here, primary on the left, secondary on the right, the arrows facing the front panel. Primary chip will be replaced with processor 1, version 3.5. Secondary chip will be replaced with processor 2, version 3.5. Next, let's remove these EEPROMs. Place the extractor tool over the chip, and it's important to know that you do not want to pull up on the chip extractor. That will damage the socket that holds the chips in place. So you do not want to pull up. You want to simply squeeze right here. Now carefully remove the new EEPROM chips from the anti-static bag. Here you have processor 1 and processor 2. Processor 1 will go on the left, facing towards the front panel. Carefully place processor 1 so that the pins sit inside of the dip socket pinholes. It's important that you don't bend any of the pins and that all the pins are connected correctly. Now with the pins all sitting in the holes, apply pressure with your thumb and your knuckle, pressing down. Make sure there's no bent pins. Make sure you're not missing any pins and that the orientation is correct. Processor 1 on the left, facing the front panel. Next, do the same thing with processor 2. If a pin gets bent, carefully bend that pin so that it's straight again. Now that all the pins are sitting in the pin socket holes, carefully press down and seat the chip. Now that the chips have been seated properly, double check the orientation. Processor 1 on the left, the arrow facing the front panel. Processor 2 on the right, arrow facing the front panel. Now place the lid back on the clasp. Now that the lid is back on the clasp, reconnect the power to make sure that the clasp will power up correctly. Turn on the clasp unit, make sure all the lights are lighting up on the front panel buttons. The screen should say tape machine not connected. If you don't see this, quickly turn off the unit, disconnect the power, remove the lid, and check the installation of your EEPROM chips very carefully.